Hi, and welcome to this Tech Insights video. My name is Mary, and I'm an application engineer here at IFM Effector. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to use the IFM IO-Link library in the CODESYS software for use with our CR displays and Ethernet IP masters. So, let's get started. To begin, let me show you where you can download the IFM IO-Link library for your CR display. If you go to our website and enter the part number of your CR display, for example, in this video, I am using the CR1077 and type startup. You will then scroll down to where it says startup package and click on it. And then you can scroll down to where you see IFM CR1077 and download this IFM IO-Link library package. In our previous video, we showed you how to establish communication with our CR displays and Ethernet IP masters, as well as how to create your first program. So now that you have your IFM IO-Link library downloaded, let me show you how to install that into your program. First, you will go to where it says Library Manager and double click. You will then go to where it says Library Repository and click on that to open that window. You will then click Install and go to where you have your IFM IO-Link library downloaded. You will then click on this and hit open. For reference in this video, I already have the IFM library downloaded, so I will not be clicking open. So now that you have installed your library, you will then click on Add Library, go to Application, and click where it says IFM IO-Link Library, and click OK to install it into this program. So now that your library is added, you will create a new program under Applications. To do this, you will go where it says Applications and right-click and go to Add Object. You will then click on POU. Give it a meaningful name and select your implementation language. Then click Add. So now on the right-hand side under General, you will drag in an empty box into your first rung. You will then click on the three question marks and click on the three dots. You will then go to where it says IFM IO-Link and click on the cyclic function block and click OK. Then you can give it a meaningful name and click OK. Now that our function block is added, let's assign the appropriate variable names. First, we have the Ethernet IP adapter, which is going to be the IO-Link master name that you gave under the Ethernet IP scanner. So for this video, it is IOMaster1. Next, you have the pointer to your input and output arrays, which is the variables that we gave in the previous video, which you can find here. If you double click on your IO master and go to Ethernet IP IO mapping, you'll see that I named them input master one and output master one. So if we go back to the function block, you will do ADR parentheses input master one and ADR parentheses output master one. So next on the function block, you have the Modbus slave variable. That is because these function blocks can also be used with our Modbus IO-Link masters. In today's video, we are using an Ethernet IP master, so we do not need to enter anything in this variable. Next, you have the AL ports 4 or 8. This is where you are going to enter how many ports your master has. You can do this by typing AL ports dot, and it'll populate either a 4 or 8 port option. In this video, we are using an 8-port master, so you can click on that and hit enter. Next, you have your port process data size. If you begin to type ALPD size and then period, it'll populate all the options that you have for your port process data size. The factory default setting is 32 bytes, so you can double-click on that and hit enter. The ports on your IO-Link master can be configured for digital inputs and digital output modes. You can do this by double-clicking on your IO-Link master. You will then go to Connections, and below you can see there is port mode for each port. In this video, I am going to set port 5's mode to a digital input by double-clicking on this and going to the drop-down window and selecting digital input pin 4 and pressing enter. So now if I go back to our function block, and I go to where it says digital input port 5, you can name this digital input to anything you want. And press enter and hit OK. Then you will right click on the function block and you can hit remove unused function block call parameters, and it'll take away any of the variables you have not named. So now you can see your simplified function block with the variables that you are using. Now that you have your cyclic function block in order to parse your IO-Link master data, let me show you how to add a function block for our IO-Link sensors. First, you can right click and insert a rung below. Then you will drag in an empty box from the general tab on the right as before. You will then click on the three question marks and go to the three dots. This time under IFM IO-Link, you will go to the sensors function block folder. Here we have function blocks for all of our IO-Link devices. In this video, I'm going to use the PN_PI function block by clicking on it and hitting OK. You can then press enter and give it a meaningful name. You then need to assign it to the Cyclic Master 1. Enter the port that the PI is on your master. In this instance, it is on port 3. And you will then enter the gradient for your IO-Link data, which you can find in the IO device description PDF of your specific sensor. Our PI2798 has a gradient of 0.1, so you'll press enter. Then on the right-hand side of your function block, you need to go through and delete all the question marks. And your function block is now ready to bring in your PI data. So now that you have your function blocks added, you will need to add the program that you created to your task on the left-hand side. So I will drag Program Master 1 into the task to assign it to that task. You will then go to Build in order to build your program. And then you can log in. And then you can click on the play button to start your program. And now you can see that the vendor ID and device ID of your PI has pulled in, and you can begin to see your pressure data below. So that concludes this Tech Insights video on using our IFM IO-Link library in your CODESYS software for use with your CR display and Ethernet IP master. As always, you can check out our website for more helpful information, or you can contact us at info.us@ifm.com or call into 1-800-441-8246 to speak with somebody who can assist you. Thank you for your time and have a great day.